Well, they see it and now they do volunteer to see the students every 2 weeks.
Starting or something?
No, I didn't know
that.
I've never heard this sound before. It's fascinating.
Early Māori used to wrap their babies in these leaves. Some of the trees that are in a more protected area, the leaves are absolutely enormous. But they have these little white flowers that just stick straight up, that form, that go to a very prickly seed. And here's one here.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And they open at the top and disperse their seed, but they're quite prickly.
What's it called?
Fau, W-H-A-U.
Right.
Yeah. Have the mallard, like, of course, that we'd rather not have, but you had a huge number, that the black shit, black cormorant, I think it might be, had a huge number actually nesting in it. Third eye when they're born, right in the top of their head. Oh, that one just moved. Where did it go? Sense the warmth of the sun. Those two are not obliging as much as I would like. I'll check the two things like that. And each little cavity has a hole to the exterior.
Ah, it's a wonderfully
and they can come and go. It is.
Nesting. Very clever.
These were the brainchild of one of our well-known entomologists. But we sometimes find these in the hedges at home. And if you're silly enough to leave your gum boots, your Wellington boots, by the back door. That's an older bird.
Because it's got grey on the top of its head.
No. I only know because the older birds put their beak right around the feeder.
Yeah.
The younger birds end up with it dribbling all the way down their front and wasting it.
So he's a bit canny, this one.
They've
then,
worked
isn't?
It out, yes. Oh, that one has taken all the nuts from over here and now it's worked out the sum in here. Oh. Cheeky bird. Oh, there's a lot around now.
Yeah, loads of them.
I think we should leave them. I'm going to give them a picture.
I think one of those, the two I think, is going to be a bit of a dog fight.